This video, I like to show you how to calculate A star, the weight of A star in this automaton. And that means, well, you probably remember it from regexes that include zero repetitions of A, so epsilon and 1A and the concatenation of 2As and so on and so on. And all this together is a set of A star. And we want here, there are actually two tasks. One is to get the weight in the real semi-ring and one in the tropical semi-ring. And as before, the main thing you want to remember is how to properly use this definition of how to calculate the weight. So, this calculation states that we have to do an infinite number of additions, so well, it's not always going to infinity, so let's just have a look at this. So first we need the weight of the word zero times in this automaton, and that by definition is a neutral element. In this case it's the zero. So in this video, I will do the calculation for the real semi-ring in the first line. So I need the zero for the real semi-ring. I need it in the first line. And for the tropical semi-ring, the zero, you see that it's at the second last position. For the tropical semi-ring, this is infinite. So then we want to do an addition. Let's look at the addition later, but let's look at the weight, at the next weight, and that's the weight of one times the word. So in this case, one times the word in the automaton, this is 1.5, so I need the 1.5 weight for both the real calculation and for the tropical semi-ring. Then let's have a look at the this one. Let's have a look at the next thing in line, which is, well, let's use this color. That is a multiplication of two times those words, so that means we have to look at those multiplication symbol, which for the real semi-ring is the usual multiplication. So I need to multiply the weight with itself. So for the real semi-ring, when I multiply it with itself, it's 1.25. And for the tropical semi-ring, our multiplication is the addition. So we have to double this and we get 3, because I have to add this to itself. Now I could just go on. You will see that for the next weight, I will have to do the multiplication 3 times, so that means that for the next weight in this sequence, I will get an even lower weight, and for the next in the tropical semi-ring, I will get an even higher weight. So let's just skip this for now, so we can see how this goes on. Now let's have a look at the addition we have to do. And the addition in the abstract semi-ring, it's at the second position. In the real semi-ring, it is a plus. So for the real semi-ring, we have to add all the weights to each other, and then we have to add an infinite number of more weights to it. So as you can see, all of the weights will be one, will be greater than one. So that means when I always add one to each other, then I will end up with an infinite weight for A star in the real semi-ring. Now for the tropical semi-ring, our addition is the minimum. That means I'm taking, for the tropical semi-ring, I'm taking the minimum of all of these weights. And as you can see here, well, as I stated before, the weights will increase because I always have to add them to each other. So this one is the lowest weight I will get in this whole sequence. So for the tropical semi-ring, the weight of A star is 1.5. Well, and that's how you do the calculation for word star in both semi-rings.